Hi there, StarForce. My name is Xandra. You may also know me as Nova or StarForce Rebel Cosplay, and welcome to the Nova Show. I'm really, really excited about launching this vlog. I think there's going to be a lot of really amazing things on here. I have some great guests lined up. I'm going to be talking to a lot of great members of the Yamato community, and most of all, we're finally going to have some more fan content for Starblazers on the internet, so woohoo! Yay! I'm super excited about this because this is really one of the first vlogs of its kind, and I can't wait to talk about the show that I'm passionate about and I know you're passionate about too. So once again, thank you so much for joining. My name is Xandra. You may know me as StarForce Rebel Cosplay, or you may have seen me post in some of the Yamato fan groups on Facebook. However you got here, I'm really glad that you did because I have a lot of really exciting things to share with you. For those of you unfamiliar, Starblazers is the American version of the beloved anime Space Battleship Yamato, which first aired in Japan in 1974. The Yamato was a real battleship in World War II revered by the Japanese. Although it was sunk during the war, its legacy would live on forever when a brand new series featuring the ship, now outfitted to be a space battleship, would capture the hearts of all of Japan. The creator of the story was Leiji Matsumoto, a legendary Japanese artist who anime fans may know for works such as Captain Harlock, Galaxy Express 999, and Queen Millennia. When the show sailed into the U.S. as Starblazers, it was an instant hit amongst people of all ages. Unlike a lot of programs at the time, Starblazers delved deep, dealing with topics such as uncertainty, leaving loved ones behind, making difficult choices, and even death in later episodes. It was also a serial show, which kept viewers coming back for more every time, as opposed to being a show you could just catch every once in a while. Starblazers was a game changer and really paved the way for the anime culture of America we have today. So, if you've been to a convention or cosplayed an anime character, in a way, you have Starblazers to thank for that. It paved the way for shows like Robotech, Voltron, and of course, the countless imported shows from the early 80s to today. Quite a few months ago, my boyfriend decided to show me a show that would change my life forever. You see, he was always telling me about this show that he watched when he was a kid that was so exciting and changed his life, and he really carried it with him as an adult throughout the years. And that little show, of course, was Starblazers. He was always telling me how excited he was to rush home from school and see it, and that nothing could take him away from the TV while it was on. And once he showed me the first episode, I knew he was absolutely right. I fell in love with it. From all the amazing characters, to the great music, to the stories, I was just instantly won over. I especially fell in love with the character of Nova for so many reasons. I mean, she was just everything a character should be.
Nova's a fearless crew member dedicated to her cause. She's beautiful, but not full of herself. She's intelligent and quick-thinking, so much so that she has several roles on the ship. Whether she's nursing injured crew members, overseeing the radar, planning strategies, or exploring unknown planets, Nova gives it her all, unafraid of anything. However, she's still vulnerable and relatable, and is the perfect love interest for Derek Wildstar, or Susumi Kodai, while still being her own unique character and not just the token girl. She's a great role model for women and girls of all ages, and in a time when we're celebrating amazing female characters, it's time Nova, or Yuki Mori, got the recognition that she deserves.
As I started to delve deeper into the Starblazers fandom, I was really sad when I found there really wasn't a lot of fan content for the show, especially not on the American side of things. I, of course, found the amazing site, Our Starblazers, run by the great Tim Eldred, who is actually going to be a current guest on the show, so look forward to definitely hearing some great stuff from him coming up. But aside from his wonderful website, you're not going to find a lot of content highlighting the impact that Starblazers had in the U.S., which was quite big from what I've heard from a lot of fans. Many kids recall rushing home from school just like my boyfriend did to watch it and sing along with the opening title, which of course is like the most catchiest theme ever.
And a lot of people just really have these fond memories of it. So unlike things like Star Trek or Star Wars or Doctor Who or any of the other great geek fandoms, the difference between those and Starblazers was that there wasn't a lot of marketing. In the United States, there wasn't a toy line easily accessible to kids. There wasn't a lot of advertising for it like there were for other shows, so even though it's very well remembered by the people who saw it and loved it, it's kind of slipped under the radar for future generations. Hence the creation of this vlog. We're going to be talking about all kinds of amazing things Yamato, from character analyses, to interviews, to street interviews, to talking with the cast and crew, and just highlighting some great fans and great contributions like some of our modelers, like some fellow cosplayers like me. It's going to be great, and I'm really, really excited that you're going to be a part of it.